Check 1, 2. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we've reached the finals. Coming up here in just a moment, we already know the G7 car will start 6th, and we know Logan Sather will start 7, shotgun on the field. And now we will determine the other 5 starting positions. First off, I'll introduce you. All right, Philip goes first. Philip, you won heat number four. You take the first draw. And let's figure out what number Philip Liestad has. Philip Liestad will start P5. All right, Philip Liestad will start the finals in fifth. Bill Timm's next. Bill Timm, the Greenbush legend, draws P number four. P4 for Bill Timm. Next up, we'll bring in the co-promoter of the Little Fork race coming up on Sunday, July 9th in Little Fork at the Northern District Fair in Little Fork. Dylan Horn will take his number.
Yay, Dylan!
D. Horn draws the pole. The pole belongs to the 49 of Dylan Horn. We got three draws left. Would you two like to play rock, paper, scissors? One, two, three, shoot. All right, you start second, you start third. The G7 will be sixth, and Logan Sather will start shotgun. We will allow these cars 5 minutes for repairs and then a 12-lap final here at the Willie Walleye Autocross. We'll be right back. Ethan, with the name Willie Walleye Autocross Champion. Here is your... Matt Gustafson, your winner.
Yeah, sure.
All right, guys. High Octane Media here at the Lake of the Woods County Fairgrounds. Willie Walleye Weekend Autocross. The first time joined here with the winner, Matt Gustafson. Matt, you're going home with some hardware, but you're going home with a brand new fishing pole.
That's very nice. Thank you.
So how long have you been racing? We seen you in Little Fork last year. You won there, and now you're back to back in this G7 machine.
You know, I can't even think of the exact number of years. It's been a long time.
Been doing this a while, huh? All right, so we got to see in Little Fork trying to take that fair race. Hey, Dylan Horn's going to be over there waiting for you. He was here today, and fortunately he had a break, but hey, you came from the back. You had to do this the hard way. Talk about this. First autocross, first time this style of race has happened here at the Lake of the Woods County Fairgrounds. Talk about that race. Talk about going through the ringer to get to the final.
It's nice. It's a little tight, but it's fun. Hard, close racing. I got a lot of races.
That paid off. You get a paycheck, you got a trophy, and this brand new CTK custom rods fishing rod here for winning today. Matt Gustafson, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, back here at the Lake of the Woods County Fairgrounds, just wrapped up the autocross. I've kind of got the Northern Bush Car Hall of Fame standing back here. We'll go in order from right here. Introduce yourself.
Keefer Kynes, DJ McGregor,
Thomas Johnson, yeah.
Bill Tim.
Mike Reber.
Candace Ness.
Now you guys do this all summer, all over the northwest part of Minnesota. The leader is kind of up that fella right there. So we'll get Bill up here first.
Put him up front.
We'll get Billy up here first. Bill, how long have you been doing this?
Since 17.
You were 17.
Bill, since 2017.
2017. Now Bush Baja racing has really picked up in the last few years. Talk about how you met this great crew.
Well, tell you what, I've been blessed with meeting quite a few people in my area. They run the Baja's, and they've done wonders. I first met DJ, and it kind of worked out with Johnny, Hogan, a few others. Remember that last year, the year before. I mean, now we're brothers. I mean, we sisters also. They need something, we got it, they have it. We need something, they got it, we have it.
Now, I'm going to pull the husband and wife forward because we have to settle a little dispute here.
That was nice, Kevin.
You beat your husband today. But he said he could have done you dirty, so...
I knew he would say that.
Does this happen all the time with you two?
We've never raced together.
So this was the first year today. Perfect. Now, how was it racing against the husband?
Well, she beat him.
I don't know.
Now, did it ever go through your head that, hey, if I break this car and it's on his car, he still has to fix it anyway?
Right.
Perfect. She broke it today, the brand new inner tie rod.
I know you told me you were working on it to get him going to come up here.
Yeah, I pushed hard to get him up here. Keeper was there to help. And Fast Graphics let us use the shop, use the lift, made it a lot easier. So.
Well, now we'll bring John up. John, how long have you been at this?
About the same time as Bill.
Now, I've seen you guys everywhere. I've seen you. The first time I think I saw you race was in Middle River the first time they did it. Talk about what it's like coming out here with this family. I mean, your daughter races?
Daughters race,
family races. What's that like racing with your family and having a new hobby with it?
It's fun. They like it. I like it. We do truck too and cars.
And there is the daughter's boyfriend.
Yep.
So if he ever has to ask for any approval of anything, you just remember anything that's happened on the racetrack?
Yep.
Oh, Tommy,
run. We'll settle it.
All right, now I'm going to bring DJ up. DJ, you didn't race today, but you have been all over the state. You are kind of the guy that's the schedule maker for these events. Talk about that. Talk about what got you into this.
Like two guys on a board, they talked me into it. I went to the end of 2018 just to kind of test the truck for the next year. Running every summer, multiple vehicles. I try and bring two because there's always a problem. Schedule people just kind of get it to me and I get it on the schedule.
First off, I definitely appreciate it. I know you do the Enduros for Grand Rapids. You're on there. Wadena's Enduros. Couple Autocross now?
Yep.
Their lifeline.
Yep, he is. And we thank you for that. I know everybody here appreciates it. Now let's get the pit crew saved you.
Yeah.
absolutely. I was just going to run on the flat tire, but they come running with it. That's the first time I think we've ever made a successful tire change and it didn't get expunged.
I think that's the first time in any
autocross. I couldn't do our Baja rules, otherwise we wouldn't have been there.
Right. It's something new. This was always going to be an experiment.
Autocross, so don't get the rules.
There's four laps left, and I was going to race on the
Josh floor. Stock, if you're watching this, I apologize. All right, so first time up and down. What did you think of the atmosphere up here?
It was good. There was no complaining that I know of.
In the car,
it flowed good.
A little short. I know it's autocross.
The track was a little short, but it got quick at the end once this snot burned up.
Oh, don't worry. The big girl's waiting for July the 16th.
Yeah, I heard. They're using the big truck.
But not
That's
least.
My birthday, so.
Oh, cool. Last but not least.
Well, then we'll have to bring along.
Hogan Lundy, come up here. I saved you for last for a reason. Now, Hogan, this was a big event for you today, you know. Big deal. Autocross first one. In 6 days, you're doing something a little different. Tell the folks what you're doing in 6 days.
Getting married.
You're getting married. Yeah. And she was here today.
Yep. She paints all my cars.
The chief car painter. The chief car painter, and now the future in 6 days, Mrs. Lundy. Congratulations on the wedding and thanks for coming up here.
Thank you.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Minnesota Baja crew, High Octane Media. Thank you for coming
up. Thank you.